In this video, we'll look at viewing your scene in Maya, starting with the default cameras and navigation controls. By default, a single viewport takes up the workspace with the perspective camera, as it does in Softimage. But you can change layouts in different ways, as is covered in the video, Customizing Maya's Layout. You can tap the spacebar to toggle between a single pane and the previous layout. And if you want the viewports to take up the whole screen, press Ctrl plus spacebar. As in Softimage, only the active viewport is updated during playback by default. The active viewport is the last one in which you clicked. To change this, open the Preferences window for the Time slider. Change the Update View option from Active to All so that all viewports will be updated. The default perspective camera gives the same type of view as the user camera in Softimage. And the orthographic cameras are the same as their counterparts in Softimage. The camera's name is displayed in green at the bottom of the viewport, which is sometimes difficult to see. You can use these default cameras in a similar way that you use the viewpoint cameras in Softimage, but the difference is that in Maya, they are actual cameras. You can do a hardware or software render from them, or create a flipbook, which is called a playblast in Maya. You can also select them in the outliner and set their attributes. And you can manipulate them in the viewport. However, for animation and rendering of your scene, you usually create camera rigs, which we'll look at in the next video. While you could edit a camera's transform values here to move it around the scene, chances are you'll use the navigate tools as you're working. To manipulate any camera, you can choose the navigation tools from the View Camera Tools menu, which contains many similar commands to the camera icon menu in Softimage. You can click the Options box for each tool to set up its default options. There are hotkeys for the Tumble Track and Dolly tools, which are the most common ones in Maya, as they are with the Navigate tool in Softimage. To use the Tumble tool, which is the Orbit tool to you, press Alt plus left click. To use the Track tool, press Alt plus middle click. And to use the Dolly tool, press Alt plus right click. To rectangle zoom, press Ctrl plus Alt and drag over the area where you want to zoom in. You can also use the 2D pan and zoom tool, which doesn't actually move the camera. You can use this tool for viewing details in specific areas and for rotoscopy work with image planes that are attached to the camera, which we'll cover in another video. This is similar to using the pixel zoom tool for rotoscoped images in Softimage. You can click its icon in the title bar or press the forward slash hotkey to activate this tool. And open its options box to switch modes between 2D pan and 2D zoom. Press Ctrl and drag over an area to do a rectangle zoom. Then press the forward slash hotkey or click its icon again to deactivate this tool. If you want to undo any navigation change, you can choose View, Undo View Change, or press Alt plus Z, as in Softimage. To redo that change, choose Redo View Change or press Alt plus Y, also as in Softimage. You can also toggle among the previous camera views by pressing the open bracket key, or the next camera views by pressing the close bracket key. You can set up how the camera transitions from one view to the next in the Preferences window. When these options are on, the camera moves smoothly between views, But you'll probably want to keep these options off so that the camera snaps from one view to the next, which is faster and more useful for blocking out shots. To return to the camera's default view, choose View Default View or press Alt plus Home, which is the same as pressing the R key in Softimage. You can frame the selected object in a view by pressing F, which will be familiar for you. And frame it in all views by pressing Shift plus F. To frame all objects in a view, either press A or press F with nothing selected. And to frame all objects in all views, press Shift plus A. Like the Center Selection Camera command in Softimage, you can choose View Look at Selection in Maya. This tracks the camera so that the selected objects are at the center of the viewport, but it doesn't zoom the camera as happens when you frame selected objects. Memo cams are a great feature for keeping specific camera angles and settings. You can create something similar in Maya called bookmarks. It's not as fast to create bookmarks as memo cams, but you can create an unlimited amount of them. The View Predefined Bookmarks menu lists the preset bookmarks that define the default views for the default cameras. To create a new bookmark, set the camera angle you want for a specific camera and choose View Bookmarks Edit Bookmarks. Click New Bookmark and give it a name and description. You can also add it to the current shelf. Click Apply and close the bookmark editor. The bookmark is saved as part of the camera's attributes. To use a bookmark, make sure that the camera is active in a viewport, then select the bookmark from the View Bookmarks menu, or click its icon on the shelf. In the next couple of videos, we'll create some custom camera rigs as well as create image planes to do rotoscopy.